Hey, it's Pete. I'm in Shanghai, China today, and I'm at a very cool space called Hackerspace, where geeks get together and play with various technology, including a lot of robotics-related stuff. And today, I have the pleasure of talking to Ricky Yi, and Ricky's the founder of a company called DFRobot, and he's going to tell us a little bit about what they're up to in terms of making Arduino kits, which is quite cool, actually. And so we're really happy to be here. Thanks for coming.
Thank you.
So Ricky, first tell me a little bit about DFRobot and the high level and what you guys do.
Right. DFRobot is actually start from 2007, and we are probably the first company to introduce Arduino in China. And then we formed the official company in 2008, started building Arduino kits and robots. And the main target is for education and hobbyists at the very beginning. And then we start growing and target more industry level for customers.
Great. So just to set the stage for all the geeks out there who might not know what Arduino is, tell us a little bit about what's cool about Arduino and what the big deal is.
I think Arduino is the open source hardware, as everybody knows, and it's first designed for interactive work. So the main purpose of Arduino is to bridge the gap for for software developer and the actual physical world. So it's the link between software and actual work. So Arduino is an easy to use board, which a software programmer can just simple click few buttons and burn the programs into the board. And then you have the capability to control the actual sensors, to read data from sensors, to control the actuators such as the motors. And with the motors, you can do a lot of things. It's just based on your imaginations.
Cool. You have an Arduino board here. I think this is one of your kits.
Yeah,
can you just show us briefly what the hardware looks like?
Yeah, so this is the standard Arduino board. And you can see it's very simple, and it's elegant and beautiful. And this is the our product for we call this I/O expansion shield. So what this do is it's actually expand the capability of Arduinos. So you can see it's just simply stuck on. And with this board, you can see there's a lot of pin out, which expand the pins for Arduinos. And also you have the a wireless communication socket, which you can give the Arduino a wireless communication capability, such as the XB modules, which is very popular in the industry. Also, this gives you IS-23485 communication port as well. So with this board, you can very easy to expand the capability of Arduino. And also, it's designed for some kits like this, because this is a joystick module, right?
I see.
So with this module, you can do a lot of gaming or motion control sort of things. But with standard Arduino, it's not that easy. You needed to hardwire a lot of cables to this module. But with this I/O expansion shield, what you need to do is just plug on a pin, and
cool.
Then write some code. Job done. It's that kind of easy.
That's great. So talk to me a little bit about the software that you use to control these devices.
Mm-hmm.
Is that something very obscure or obtuse, or is that how does that work when you want to talk to an Arduino device with software?
Basically, we're using standard Arduino IDE. It's derived from the processing language. It's kind of a Java kind style programming format. So I think most of the software programmers can pick up that very easily, maybe in an hour or 2 hours.
Mm.
What you need to do is just a standard programming IDE. You're writing types of codes, and what you do is just standard compile and upload, and job done.
Okay, interesting. And now the Arduino platform is open source. I guess I feel like I know what that means when it comes down to open source software,
yeah.
But what is open source hardware? What does that mean?
Open source hardware is they just gives you all the details about the hardware, such as the schematics, the design file, probably the layout file, the firmware, also the BOM, which is the bill of material. So with these four files, actually can easy to put this to a factory, and they can base, they can manufacture products based on this file.
I see.
So for open source hardware, which means you can very easy to copy and reproduce the product.
So one of these boards, an Arduino board, costs around, what, $20 or so?
Yeah, something like that.
So if this board costs $20 and you don't want to spend $20 for every piece of product that you deliver to a customer, what you're saying is you're able to send the spec, send this to a factory where it can be mass produced for much cheaper.
Yeah. I think the most the application so far is they using Arduino to do a rapid prototyping, and for mature product they will design a new board, maybe based on Arduino, maybe not. For that purpose, you can save a lot of cost because all the files is open, so you can very easy to modify and reproduce the product by itself.
That's great. So it's basically for those of us who do startups. And understand the whole concept of rapid iteration.
Yeah.
Arduino allows you to do quicker cycles with hardware. Is that right?
That's correct, yeah.
So when it comes down to real world products and applications, is Arduino just something for geeks who like robots, or is there some real world applications that you've seen in the market that are interesting?
I mean, if you're interested, if you know Arduino about it, you know how Arduino is applied in various kind of works, such as the interactive art, educations, robotics, even home automation as well. But that's the past. From last year, we have several customers actually come to us looking for a co-development for an industrial product. The recent finished product is called a stomach probe product, which using an industry stomach probe.
A stomach probe?
Yeah,
okay.
Stomach probe. So they actually have asked other companies, traditional companies using a PLC or other microcontroller to do the development, and they figure out the cost, and the development time is not a good thing. And such as for a standard one is like 12 months, and for us, I mean, we saved time to 1 month. We finished the project in a month, and then we saved the cost about 1/5. So which is a great.
So there's arguably ways to put real products in the market based on Arduino technology that already supports certain kinds of standards compliance,
yes,
et cetera.
Yes, that's right, because Arduino itself has already passed all the tests. So the design is mature and reliable. And the second case is we recently working with a company which trying to design a Segway style transportation tools. And they designed it for Walmart, actually. And they're using Arduino as the main controller. And they sell 5,000 in a year for that product based on Arduino. That's an amazing thing.
Well, I find it fascinating as an entrepreneur and a geek myself that the Arduino platform allows me to create hardware-based solutions and then send them off for manufacturing and potentially even as a low capital style lean startup operation produce a real world useful hardware based solution. That's fascinating.
Yeah, that's the biggest part of Arduino. That's the spirit of Arduino. I mean, using Arduino you can produce a lot of end application, not the half product application. But we think Arduino is in the industry level, it's just in the middle. It gives you the capability to run the prototyping, to do research, but it's not used for the end product.
Right. So do you think if I come up with a really cool application, a hardware-based application solution, that Foxconn will want my business?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. If you have such kind of idea, you can use Arduino to do prototyping and manufacture.
Yeah, that's great. Very cool.